Hi guys! Good morning!
Good morning!
Today we would like to share this story from Mark chapter 6 verse 41 to 44 as we pray for provision. And this story is very familiar for all of us, but as we read it, we just pray that we would trust God that it would happen also to us, because again, the same God that they have here is the same God that we have right now. If we have the faith that they had, we can still have that faith that we can that they had before.
So, from verse 41, Jesus took the 5 loaves and 2 fish, looked up toward heaven, and blessed them. Then, breaking the loaves into pieces, he kept giving the bread to the disciples so they could distribute it to the people. He also divided the fish for everyone to share. They all ate as much as they wanted, and afterward, the disciples picked up 12 baskets of leftover bread and fish. A total of 5,000 men and their families were fed. And bibigyan lang ako ng konting background yung mga verses prior dun sa binasa natin. Kasi sobrang na-encourage din talaga kami about this. Na parang dun sa start, nasa remote place kasi sila si Jesus with his disciples, and yun nga yung maraming tao kasi they were trying to follow God. They were trying to follow Jesus kasi narinig nila na nag-heal siya ng tao. And then, sabi nung isa sa mga disciples, parang, "This is a remote place and it's already getting late. Send the crowds away so they can go to the nearby farms and villages and buy something to eat." So parang yung mga disciples, what I like about this dito sa account ni Mark, yung pagkakakwento niya, parang yung mga tao, yung 5,000 men and yung families na yun, hindi naman sila nag-a-ask kay Lord. Parang hindi sila nagde-demand na, "Jesus, pakainin mo kami, anong kakainin namin ngayon? Nandito kami sa isang remote place." Pero yung disciples yung nag-isip na parang, "Lord, pauwiin mo na yan kasi wala tayong mapapakain, nasa remote place tayo." Pero yung response ni Jesus dun sa disciple was, "You feed them." Parang ganun lang kasimple. Parang sabi lang ni Jesus, "Okay, you feed them." Tapos sabi lang ng disciple, parang, "Anong papakain namin? With what?" they asked. We'd have to work for months to earn enough money to buy food for all these people. Tapos sabi lang ni Jesus, "How much bread do you have?" he asked. "Go and find out." Tapos sinabi na nga ng disciple na mayroong 5 loaves of bread lang and 2 fish. And what I like about this lang, and yung nakaka-encourage lang about this is that yung disciples, they were worried. Parang, "Kailangan ko mag-work for how many months just to provide food, enough food for these people." Pero si God was very calm about it. Si God was, parang, yung response niya lang, "Okay, magkano ba yung meron ka? Or ilan ba yung meron ka?" And whatever we have right now sa mga houses natin, whatever we have sa government natin, yung amount na money na meron tayo, we hope and we pray na we would trust God, that God will multiply that. Yeah. That even if sa physical eyes, parang di talaga kaya, hindi mapapakain itong 5,000 families na to. But I pray and we pray na every day we would remember that God can multiply whatever we have, because He is our provider.
Yeah. And I think you were talking, may dalawang bagay lang ako na nag-struck sa akin. First is, I think the people went there without parang asking for food din. Pumunta sila doon without asking for food or anything. Mm-hmm. But they went there to spend time with God. They went there to spend time with Jesus because they wanted to hear something from Jesus. Mm-hmm. They wanted to hear the teachings of Jesus. They wanted to spend time with Him. They wanted to know more about Him. Again, in this situation, we know that we need provision. But more than the provision, we pray that we would look for the provider, which is Jesus. We would look for the God that we need. Kasi siya yung bibigay na security sa atin. And the rest would follow. Provision would follow. Everything would follow. Healing would follow. But the most important thing that we look for is the healer, the provider, the God, Jesus. We fix our eyes on Him. And second, kumbaga, they all ate as much as they wanted. After looking for the provider gave the provision more than that, what they need. Parang mm-hmm. more than what they needed. Hindi lang sila pampatawid or pangtawid gutom. Pero yung na-feel talaga nila, yung sinabi dito ni Mark, they all ate as much as they wanted. Kumbaga, busog-busog sila. Mm-hmm. That's how God provides it. He would provide when you would just have faith in Him. Just look for Him, look for the provider, and fix our eyes on Him. So, yeah, let's pray. Lord, thank you for this story, God, that, wow, 5 loaves, 5 fish, 2 fish, grabe, na feed mo yung 5,000 men with their families, Lord. Maraming salamat with 2 fishes that we have, with 5 loaves that we have. Lord, whatever we have right now in our nation, in our country, in our barangays, Lord, you're gonna multiply that, Lord. The same miracle that they experience is the same miracle that we can experience, Father. Lord, we know that we know the, yung, it's right to know the facts or it's right to know what we have. Yes, Lord, there's wisdom there, but Lord, we pray, Father, that as we know the facts, we would have faith also, God. We would try to face every single thing or every single day with faith, Lord, trusting you that you would provide for the things that we need, trusting you that you would spare us from this situation, God, trusting you that you would save us, Father. Thank you, God, because it says in your word you were the same yesterday, today, and forever. So the God that provided for those people, 5,000 men and with their families, is the same God that would provide for our nation and our families in our barangays, Lord. Maraming salamat, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Lord, we thank you because as we go to you, as we spend time with you, as we look to you, God, you will provide everything that we need, God. Even if we don't ask for it, you will provide for it, Lord. And we thank you, God, even for the people, Lord, that you are using to extend, Lord, yung blessings nila to other people. Thank you, Lord, for everyone who's donating, everyone who's starting all these charities, God. And thank you, Lord, because even yung smallest amount that anyone could give, you would multiply it. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity for everyone to help. Kasi right now, God, kahit wala namang limit yung donations, wala namang kailangan higher than 10,000 yung ibibigay mo. But thank you, God, kasi even sa 200 pesos, even sa mga 20 pesos ng mga estudyante, even with that, Lord, yung little act of faith of sharing what they have, Lord, it's creating a huge impact, Lord, with with our nation, Lord, with the families that are being blessed by those donation drives, by those charities, God. And thank you, Lord, because you are a faithful God and you are a generous God and you are able to multiply whatever we have, Lord. We can live in peace. We can live with joy, with contentment, with satisfaction. We could live without worries or anxiety kung anong kakainin namin sa everyday lives namin. Because we know that we can trust you, Lord, that you will provide for our needs even more than what we need, God. Thank you, Lord, for your love for us, God. Thank you na hindi ka napapagod na mahalin kami, hindi ka napapagod na mag-provide para sa amin, God.
Yeah.
In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen, amen. So again, guys, we encourage you to read your Bible, read the stories. Dito talaga tayo makakuha ng assurance natin. Dito tayo makakuha ng mga bagay na kailangan natin no, pangharap ng situations na to. Trusting God, knowing God, looking for Him, fixing our eyes on Him, it would give us assurance. And we pray that God would provide for every single thing that we need in our nation. Don't stop praying with your family, with your friends, with ikaw sarili mo. Just pray after this video.